9:34 a.m. Thursday, March 22nd, 2018. See how the terrorist bitch kind of turned out, right? The bitch just turned it down from a 3.6. That cow bitch Monica Devon and whatever bitch ass nigga over there. Yeah, these are levels. You can't feel a headache the bitch is causing you. Or any of the shit they doing to me. Yeah, I'ma find somebody to help me. Look at the levels. See it? And I'ma let this record while I go shit and shower.
Experience you had as a kid.
What traumatic experience?
See, Vanessa, that's called repression. We learned about in psychology class. Dad is blocking the memory of it because it's so horrible.
Your pet bird, Charlie?
Charlie.
See, Dad had this parakeet.
It was not a parakeet. Finch. There's a hole in the cage, and he'd fly out, just chirping all over the place. One day I came home, and I was getting ready to put on my sneakers, and I sat down on the bed. Heard a chirp. Like a muffled chirp.
You killed Charlie?
No, I didn't kill Charlie. I just sat on him. And from that point on, I swear, whenever he would see me, he would jerk. I'd come down the hallway and I'd hear him chirp, chirp, chirping away. And as soon as I'd come in and he'd look at me, he'd just stop chirping. And then he would look at me like this.
Crushing me.
Oh, yeah? Well, 20 years ago, it wasn't crushing you.
20 years ago, your leg was a lot lighter.
Well, yeah? Well, 20 years ago, you were not as beautiful as you are. Take your hands off me, woman.
Mommy, Daddy!
Come here, honey.
I think Darren's sick.
He is?
He won't run around on his wheel.
No, he's not sick, dear. He's smart. He knows that running around on that wheel is not going anywhere.
He sneezed. I heard him.
What does a hamster sneeze sound like?
What's that?
Checkup?
Of course
they can. What are you talking about? I can't give that thing a checkup.
you can, see?
Well, you want me to take him down my office?
So you can do it right here.
Do it right here. Look after the hamster. Okay, fine. All right, dear, let Dad take a look at it here. Hold on, Dr. Hamster, Huxtable here. Just put him right up there on the desk, and I'm sure that we can find something about this good little furry thing here. All right, reach down and grab him. Pull him out there. Now, this is a friend of yours, is it, ma'am? Take the cage down, please. All right, what do you think is wrong with him? All right.
He's sick.
He's sick, all right.
Cough!
What's the problem now? Let's see if he can say, oh, oh. All right, you hold on to him there. Now, put him up here. Put him up here. Heartbeat sounds strong. You put him up. Heartbeat?
Sounds fine.
All right, then put him back in again, but it seems to be okay.
I can say.
Hey, good night, ma'am.
Night.
Okay.
Thanks, Daddy.
Well,
thank you, Mommy.
Good night, dear. Good night, Darren.
Darren, get my cage. It's a great place to stay.
Fred, that was sweet of you to examine Darren like that.
Thank you.
You are such a sensitive, good, and caring parent, and a wonderful human being.
Thank you. And can I put my name in?
Okay, that's enough.
Hamster sneeze.
You couldn't hear a hamster sneeze if it was in this room.
Don't tell me. I know. I think it's a hamster sneeze when I hear a hamster sneeze.
You see, you're feeling guilty about what you did to Charlie.
What do you know about Charlie?
Honey, everybody in the world knows you sat on that bird.
It's a cold night around here for him. Sneeze, and he does sound a little congested, honey.
He was breathing funny before, mm-hmm. But I didn't want to bother him.
Yeah, well, you didn't bother me. I gave him a complete physical, didn't I?
What should we do?
First thing in the morning, we'll take him to the vet, okay?
He's sick. I know it. Karen's gonna hate me.
Karen's not gonna hate you. You didn't make him sick, dear.
Can we take him to the vet now?
Well, dear, it's 3 o'clock in the morning.
He's sick. He needs help.
Maybe we can find an all-night clinic somewhere we're taking, okay?
But this is an emergency. We should call the ambulance.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. We'll put Darren in the car, and while I'm driving, you roll down the window, you put your head out, and you say, okay? Now, here we go. Move it. Emergency. Let's go.
A truck full of tough stains, plus one powerful bull. Equals one big mess. Use Purex detergent and Clorox products together for our ultimate clean.
Oh, manatees, aka the sea cow. Oh, there's one.
Manatees in novelty. Surprising.
What's Kanafi, bro?
It's something you say to a friend.
What's not surprising? How much money Matt saved by switching to Geico? 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Attention, homeowners. Quicken Loans has some very important information regarding the U.S. government's Home Affordable Refinance Program, or HARP. We've told you about HARP in the past, And we're happy to report that nearly 3.5 million homeowners have already taken advantage of this fantastic money-saving program. But there are so many more of you who could be saving hundreds of dollars every month on your mortgage. Quicken Loans is here to help you save your money. Why Quicken Loans? The home loan experts at Quicken Loans fully understand the HARP guidelines. We'll work with you to understand your specific circumstances and strive to find the financial solution that's best for you. Then we'll guide you through each step of the mortgage refinance process to make sure that it's both simple and easy. And for 8 years in a row now, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction.
So many strange things have been happening.
Destination for mortgage servicing. If you're not familiar with HARP, it's a U.S. government program designed specifically for homeowners who have little or no equity. A great feature of the HARP program is that most HARP refinance loans do not require an appraisal, and there are fewer income verification requirements. That makes it simpler, easier, and even faster. And even if you've been denied for a HARP loan in the past, new guidelines mean that you now may be eligible. Give us a call and we'll give you a Quicken Loans mortgage review. And we'll do all we can to help you save money on your mortgage. It's simple and easy. Find out if you're eligible to take advantage of today's incredibly low interest rates and start saving money every month on your mortgage. Call Quicken Loans today or go to quickenloans.com for a mortgage experience that's engineered to amaze.
Want to give your family fast internet speed and great entertainment for an amazing price? Well, with Xfinity, you get the speed you need and the entertainment you want, now for a low price that you can't miss. Call 1-800-800-2588 for this incredible offer on Xfinity Internet and TV for only $54.99 a month for 12 months. Xfinity delivers fast and reliable internet to keep everyone knocking on the Now with even faster speed included for an amazingly low price. You can stream hit shows and live sports on the go, whenever, wherever. Call 1-800-800-2588 to get this incredible offer on Xfinity Internet and TV for only $54.99 a month for 12 months. Now with even more speed, Xfinity delivers the speed, coverage, and control you need for the ultimate in-home Wi-Fi experience. See for yourself how much value you can get out of the entertainment you want at a price you can't miss. Call 1-800-800-2588 today.
Good morning, Maryland.
Good morning, America.
We have a sick hamster.
We?
Oh, as my daughter's in the ladies' room, should be out shortly.
Please.
Dr. Cliff Huxtable.
All right. And your pet's name?
It's Darren, but it's not our pet. He's just a guest staying at the house, and he got sick, but we didn't do anything to him.
Okay, I'll just put down Darren the hamster.
Darren the hamster.
Is this an emergency?
It's 4 o'clock in the morning. It's an emergency.
Take a seat, Dr.
You're so well. What's the matter with the dog?
He's depressed. Before he could do many tricks. Stand up. Stop yelling. Stand up, boy. But you see, he used to do that on his own, like this, just like that. I'm sorry. Yeah. Now, come down now. Come down. That's a good boy. Jump off now. He's afraid of height. Down, please. That's a good boy. Now, the front legs, back legs down. He jump off. Sparky, hey, jump off. Down, that's a good boy.
Stop,
me.
Let's check Darren's throat. The glands are swollen, sweetheart.
She?
Yes, she are.
Well, concerned about your doctors, a possibility of pneumonia, bronchitis, possibly heart failure. We kept you certain about X-rays.
X-ray? Hamster X-ray?
We do a two-part series.
Really?
Abdomen's back and side.
Wow.
The cost is $55.
What cost is it? The issue of is that in addition to the $33 for the office visit?
Now, don't you start. Don't you be silly. You did everything you could.
I think I could have taken him to the vet.
Oh, honey, you didn't know.
I didn't know. I'm a doctor, dear.
Wait a minute. The x-rays cost $55.
Yes, indeed. And I also spent $17.50 on Darren number two.
You are going to buy another hamster and try to pass it off to Carolyn as Darren?
That's exactly what I plan to do.
So she gave him an eyedropper full of brandy. And after he got that, that bird started flying willy-nilly around the room and crashed into the wall. That's what Chip could be.
Now that I think about it, whenever he saw
saw Mom. He just went the other way. He gave her the same look that he gave me.
Something here for you. I was looking through the family album and I found this. It's a picture of you and Johnny.
When you look at this, am I looking strong in this nigger suit? Huh?
Yes, indeed.
With the socks falling. And look at John. Yeah, this is before the city. Oh, thank you, Dad.
You know, son, I think I better go upstairs and talk to Rudy. She could use some consoling now, too.
Yeah. you're dead now.
If you're a mom, you know that kids don't come with an owner's manual. But what if you could get instructions for the tough stuff, like teeth? We can help. Just call today to make an appointment. We're Cool Smiles, the friendly dental office that can answer all the hard questions about kids' teeth. In your very first visit, we can work on problem areas and begin a routine for great dental health. Unlike some instruction books, we explain everything in simple terms so that you know you are doing the right thing to keep your kids safe and healthy. Make an appointment for a checkup at Cool Smiles today. We make dental care easy and affordable because Cool Smiles accepts nearly all types of insurance, including Medicaid and state programs like these. So a checkup may cost you little or nothing at all. Call now to schedule an appointment. We're here to help you, Mom. It's never been easier to visit the dentist. Cool Smiles has online scheduling and is open Saturdays. We're located close to your home and we can see all your kids on the same day. Even shampoo comes with instructions, so why don't kids? We make dental care easy with simple instructions like visit Cool Smiles, brush and floss, repeat. Our fun play area and free toys get kids excited about regular Cool Smiles checkups. Our staff is trained to work with kids of all ages. Teeth tip, it's best to visit Cool Smiles before you have a toothache. But if you're already in pain, don't worry. We can get your kids fixed up. Call now to make an appointment with a Cool Smiles general dentist. Remember, we accept nearly every type of insurance, including Medicaid and these state programs. So it may cost you little or anything at all for your whole family to see the dentist. And regular checkups are important, starting as early as age one. Who needs a tooth owner's manual when you can call Cool Smiles? Call today to visit a Cool Smiles general dentist near you. Come.
Mystery phone calls a dead man that talks all that I understand. Women, they're beyond understanding.
Play your misogynist.
Misogynist? Della, you're going to have to stop dancing around during the language.
Play is a woman hater. On the other hand,
I'm exactly the opposite.
I'm not thinking about you, Paul. I'm thinking about Perry. And believe me, you were just wonderful, Louise. All that time, interest and understanding.
Perry, I don't know what you're angling for, but you might as well let her have it. Della, tell me, what would you have done if you had a client whose husband died twice?
This is MeTV,
Baltimore is home for memorable entertainment television. That's memorable. That's me.
This guy is me. But when this picture was taken, I wasn't there. It's a composite.
Somebody got that photograph. The photograph. What'd you do with the photograph?
I find it. End the problem.
Yeah? Not necessarily.
You know that third guy in the picture nobody recognized? That's him. It's my fault Ben Medlock's been hassling you about this photograph, not Lisa's. So, if you're upset, I'm sorry. Thank you. Won't you come in? Diana, you look different.
I'm serene, tranquil.
Yeah. Why not?
I just spent 6 days at the Inanna retreat. Yoga, relaxation, deep breathing. Anger out. Tranquility in. Life's too short to manifest anger, Ben.
It's just wonderful how sometimes a misfortune can turn a whole life around.
How wise you are, dear Ben. So, how's my case coming along?
Slow, Diana. Slow. We don't have a shred of proof as to who killed your husband.
But you will, won't you, Ben, dear?
I hope so, Diana. I hope so, but I have to admit, right now I'm stumped.
But I'm not paying you a small fortune to be stumped, Ben, dear. I'm paying you to prove that I didn't kill her, philandering.
I'm trying my best. Breathe, breathe in, tranquil, breathe, tranquil.
Don't patronize me, don't shit.
Maybe 30 years in the slammers, what you need?
Randy came by when she heard about Jack.
Yeah, well, when Jack came by, Carolyn was in a meeting. But Jack just barged right in, talked to her right side out, 30 seconds, and then he came out again. But on his way out, he made this remark that sounded like Carolyn was selling the clients a Warhol.
See, Jack told me that the picture in Carolyn's office showed at this 6 rows of $50 bills.
You'll see, Warhol painted a huge $1 bill, but I have never heard of him painting a lot of 50s. Besides that, I went ahead and checked the sales and the purchase records. We haven't handled a Warhol in over 2 years.
Well, tell him that. Tell him.
Well, a few minutes after Jack left, Carolyn came out of the conference room and she was really upset. And so were the guys she was meeting with.
Remember their names?
Mm-hmm. Carl Shepley and Dick Lerner.
Carl Shepley?
Yeah, do you know him?
Those are the three people that John Resnick called the night before he was murdered.
Well, yeah, you know, they're at the art gallery all the time. That's why I really couldn't understand why Carolyn got so upset.
Ever heard of an artist named Hugo Wyckoff?
Oh, I have. We handled his lithographs at the gallery. He was killed in a hit and run about a year ago.
That's right.
From the MeTV conspiracy theory files, what if the government sent federal agents into the kitchen?
I think something can be arranged.
To infiltrate Hawaii's crime syndicate.
You know better than I do all the legitimate businesses I have an interest in.
Legitimate?
Only to get caught by Hawaii Five-O's top cop.
I keep seeing your face behind bars.
Don't believe it? See for yourself.
You know, that's like coincidence, I would say.
The Wild Wild West and Hawaii Five-O. Today, starting at 5-0 Central on MeTV.
Looking for Lily Wyckoff.
That's me.
Can I ask you something? What do you call all this?
It's, you know, it's art. That's why this is art.
My name is Conrad McMasters. I'm a private investigator. I wonder if I could ask you a couple of questions about your late husband.
What about my husband?
You're saying he was a wonderful artist.
He was a great artist, like Hugo. Here, sit down.
Did he ever tell you about anybody named John Resnick?
That's the man who killed him.
Killed him?
He commissioned Hugo to do some work for him. Now, I don't know what kind of work. Hugo wouldn't say. But I do know that I had a big fight on the phone one day. And when Hugo hung up, he was scared. 2 days later, he was dead. The police tell me John Resnick had an airtight alibi. Well, I don't care. He's the one who ran Hugo down.
Did Hugo ever mention anybody named Carl Shepley?
No.
What about Carolyn Westlake or Dick Lerner?
Sure, he mentioned them. Carolyn had his work on display in her gallery. Dick Lerner bought one of his best pieces. That was the last thing Hugo saw before he was killed.
Did you happen to save some of your husband's art?
I saved all of it.
Can I see it?
Sure. Oh.
Loads are all of me, by the way. classic cars, artwork, real estate, dental practices. I'm kind of a professional leader.
Oh, isn't it?
What's going on here?
Well, all I know so far for sure is that John Redney was involved in a murder about a year ago, and that he called you at 2 o'clock in the morning the night before he was killed. He also called Carolyn Westlake and Dick Lund that same night, and they are the two people that Jack Huntington saw you with when he came barging into the conference room at the gallery the night before he was murdered. And since you seem to be at the center of all this death and destruction, I was hoping you could tell me what's going on.
Mr. Matlock, I would like to help you, but I don't know what to tell you.
Maybe you could tell me what you and Ms. Westlake and Mr. Lerner were looking at that night.
What night?
The night Jack Huntington come bursting into that conference room.
Now, that was business, Mr. Matlock. I just assumed not discuss that.
How about the next morning, around, say, 8 o'clock, when the Jack Huntington was killed? Could we discuss that, or is that business?
Memory serves, I was playing racquetball. Now, if you'll excuse me, Mr. Matlock, I have places to go.
One more question.
The Hillsdale Racquet Club.
John Resnick? My God, what else does he know?
Nothing.
What if he followed you?
He didn't.
Are you sure?
Hey, I don't know if the guy I've been tailing for 2 days has been tailing me, don't you think?
So, we're gonna go through.
You better believe we are. In 24 hours, the three of us are gonna get an awful lot of money.
To MeTV.com. Today, it's 10 things you never knew about different strokes. Find the story of the day on MeTV.com.
At Safeway Auto Glass, we know that when you're spending time with the grandkids, every minute counts. But you don't have time for a cracked windshield. That's why we show you exactly when we'll be there, saving you time so you can keep saving the world.
Building a website in under an hour is easy with GoCentral from GoDaddy. In fact, 68% of people who have built their website using GoCentral did it in under an hour. And you can too. Build a better website in under an hour with GoCentral from GoDaddy.
Baby boomers, here's something you should know. There's a serious virus out there that 1 in 30 boomers has, yet most don't even know it. A virus that's been almost forgotten. It's hepatitis C. Hep C can hide in the body for years without symptoms. Left untreated, it can lead to liver damage, even liver cancer. The only way to know if you have Hep C is to ask your healthcare provider for the simple blood test. If you have Hep C, it can be cured. For us, it's time to get tested. It's the only way to know for sure.
Have you been told you need neck or back surgery? If so, you do have a choice. Call Laser Spine Institute and say yes to a pain-free life with our minimally invasive spine surgery. It's safer than open back surgery, letting you get back to living life on your terms.
I can lift my son high over my head today.
If you have spinal stenosis, bulging or herniated disc, sciatica, or other chronic spine conditions, call 1-800-673-BACK now for your free MRI review. Thanks to a less than 1-inch incision, you'll be up and walking within hours of surgery, so you can get back to your life in days instead of months.
I feel like Laser Spine Institute was an answer to prayer.
Join the thousands of people every year who say goodbye to chronic neck and back pain with Laser Spine Institute. Make today the day you say yes to living a pain-free life.
Call 1-800-673-BACK now for your free MRI review.
See, Hugo dated this lithograph. This is what he was working on when he died.
Man knew how to draw money, didn't he?
Right down the whiskers on Grant's face.
Yeah. Jack saw something he shouldn't have seen. Carolyn and Carl Shepley and Dick Garner were afraid he might figure out what it was, so they simply killed him.
Randy. Oh, hi, Mr. Shepley. She's waiting for you in the conference room.
Great.
Don't
get away, but the car went right after him and just nailed him.
About how far away from the decedent were you when this happened?
Oh, 30, 40 feet.
Were you close enough to see the car's license plate?
Oh, yes, easily.
Do you remember it?
You bet. It was ESV-571. Georgia plates. Oh, and there was a frame around the plate saying, "Born to Shock."
Did you happen to notice the make of the car?
Yeah, it was a blue Lincoln Mark 7.
Since it's been stipulated that the defendant, Diana Huntington, owns a blue Lincoln Mark 7, license plate number ESV-571, I have no further questions.
Mr. Matlock? This car that drove past you, did you get a look at the driver?
Well, no, not a real good look, no.
So the only view you had of the car and its driver was from behind?
Right.
From behind, what did the driver look like?
Well, I was so busy memorizing the plate that I didn't look at the driver at all.
Oh, so you saw Diana Huntington's car, but you didn't see who was driving it.
Right.
It could have been anybody.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Miss Sullivan, Jack Huntington was living with you at the time of his death, is that correct?
Yes.
He had recently separated from his wife?
That's right.
Would it be more accurate to say that he was hiding from Diana Huntington?
I couldn't really say.
Well, didn't Jack Huntington give specific instructions to both his attorney and his accountant to withhold his whereabouts from the defendant?
Yes.
He was afraid of his wife's violent temper, wasn't he?
Objection, cause for speculation.
Sustained. Did Diana Huntington send a birthday card to her husband through her attorney?
Yes.
Did you happen to see that card?
Oh, I sure did.
And what did it say?
It said, "Happy birthday, dear. Wish you were dead."
Oh, that was a joke! It was a joke!
Order, Mr. Matlock, restrain your claim.
Sit down, Diana.
It was a joke! Aren't you going to say something?
Sullivan, did the defendant recently visit you and Jack Huntington at your home?
Yes.
How would you characterize her state of mind when she entered your house?
She was upset.
Upset? Didn't she burst through your front door flailing a gun?
That gun wasn't loaded, you creep! Would you get off your duff and say something?
No control over the prosecutor's questions today, Diana.
I'm not.
I just answer him honestly.
Lisa, I don't want to talk about what happened in court today. I just want to ask you something. Can I come in? So, this is how artists live. I'm comfortable with it. So is Jack. Oh, my God. Do you know that I met this for Jack with my own hands 15 years ago? Glad that he held on to something of mine. Do you know? No, my mother does. Oh, Diana, you wanted to talk to me about something?
Yes. I don't know why this is important to me, but it is.
Were you going to marry Jack?
That's your question? I don't know. We never talked about it.
Oh, come on. Two people who are presumably in love talk to each other about their future.
Yeah, we did, just not in those terms.
I know what you mean.
Getting married wasn't important to me.
I just wanted to be with Jack, that's all. Marriage was important to your generation.
My generation.
Look, Diane, I don't want to fight. You and me, we're different.
Oh, we sure are.
No?
This is wrong. I love Jack, and I guess you do too. In a very different way, we're both missing.
Do you feel bored, joyless, laugh-free?
I do.
Then ask your doctor if Diagnosis Murder is right for you. Try Diagnosis Murder this morning at 11:10 Central on MeTV. Side effects include delay, skipping work to watch Diagnosis Murder, and the urge to solve murders on your own.
So, how many of us feel completely confident in our financial future? Nobody, right? Well, that's not uncommon. So, what worries you about your financial future? Let's hear some specifics. Yes, go ahead.
I don't want to be a burden to my kids. When my husband died, it took almost all of our savings to give him a proper funeral. I honestly don't know if there's enough to bury me, let alone cover expenses should something happen.
Can you all relate to that? So let's talk about solutions. One thing you may want to get in place is a guaranteed whole life insurance policy from United of Omaha Life Insurance Company, which is a mutual of Omaha company. This is affordable coverage, which provides a cash payment, which can cover funeral expenses, bills, and other financial needs, all from a company that's been doing the right thing for its policyholders for over 90 years.
All you have to do is call or go online.
Yes.
Do I need medical exams and things like that?
No medical exams. United of Omaha Guaranteed Whole Life Insurance makes it simple. If you're between the ages of 45 and 85, you can call this number or you can go online and apply for coverage up to $25,000. Yes, ma'am.
How will my kids make a claim if they need to?
Just call United of Omaha. Most payments are on their way within 24 hours. Yes, sir.
So I can get all this just by calling?
Yes, just call this number and ask about a guaranteed whole life insurance policy. And the agent will help determine what's best for you. Make sure you call today. They'll take good care of you. If you're between ages 45 and 85, get up to $25,000 of coverage with a guaranteed whole life insurance policy from United of Omaha. No medical exam is required, and most payments are on their way within 24 hours. Call the number on your screen or visit us online today.
It's tax season in America. Time to make the most of your tax return with Mako. Our expert paint and body specialist will give your car a new look. And since Mako's tax season paint sale starts at just $2.99, your wallet will have a new look too. Mako, America's body shop.
Cooking breakfast. Getting the kids off to school.
Your mornings are busy, sometimes even hectic. We get that. That's why we don't make you wait for weather and traffic.
Get on the news today. Brings you weather and traffic on the ones. Accurate forecasts with meteorologist Anna Marie.
Grab an umbrella before you head out.
And up-to-the-minute traffic reports with Lindsay Griffin.
We have sample accidents to tell you about.
The only local newscast delivering all the information you need every 10 minutes, starting at 4:30 a.m.
Eligible for Medicare? That's a good thing. But it doesn't cover everything. Only about 80% of your Part B medical expenses. The rest is up to you. So consider an AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plan, insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company. Like any of these types of plans, they could save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. Call United Healthcare Insurance Company today to request a free decision guide. With these types of plans, you'll be able to visit any doctor or hospital that accepts Medicare patients. Join the millions who have already enrolled in the only Medicare supplement insurance plans endorsed by AARP and provided by United Healthcare Insurance Company, which has over 30 years of experience behind it. Apply for a Medicare supplement insurance plan anytime you want. So don't wait. Call United Healthcare now to request your free decision guide.
It's tax season, America. Time to make the most of your tax return with Mako. Our expert paint and body specialist will give your car a new look. And since Mako's tax season paint sale starts at just $2.99, your wallet will have a new look too. Mako, America's body shop.
You're all the way to number 16.
see what you got.
Return on your money. Can't beat that.
Beats the hell of a 2-year CD, that's for sure. I'll be in touch.
Kitty Russell, owner of the Bomb Brain Saloon.
I am the boss.
Toughest lady west of the Mississippi.
Get out of here right now, or so help me, I'll throw you out of here myself.
On Gunsmoke, today at 1 noon Central on BTV.
Oh, just remember, last is on BTV.
We'll miss you in our hearts and in the shower.
Or watching hot dog drink and martinis is like they want a beer.
Tonight at 7, 6 Central on BTV.
You always pay your insurance on time. Tap one little bumper and up go your rates. What good is having insurance if you get punished for using it? Newsflash, nobody's perfect.
For drivers with accident forgiveness, Liberty Mutual won't raise your rates due to your first accident. Switch and you could save $782 on home and auto insurance. Call 1-888-805-3166 for a free quote today. Liberty stands with you. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
From the very beginning, it was always our singular focus, a distinct determination to do whatever it takes, use every possible resource to fight cancer, and never lose sight of the patients we're fighting for. Our cancer treatment specialists share the same vision. Experts from all over the world working closely together to deliver truly personalized cancer care. Specialists focused on treating cancer using advanced technologies and more precise treatments than before. Working as hard as we can, doing all that we can for everyone who walks through our doors. This is Cancer Treatment Centers of America, and these are the specialists we're proud to call our own. Treating cancer isn't one thing we do, it's the only thing we do. Expert medicine works here. Learn more at cancercenter.com. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Appointments available now.
We just got done searching the room you leased at that industrial park, Mr. Arnold. We had a warrant, of course, Counselor. Found a printing press, two plates. One for the front of a $50 bill, one for the back. Who made the plates for you?
My clients have nothing to say.
Was it Hugo Wyckoff? We also have the whole transaction between you and Charles Beckman on videotape. In other words, the guy you dead to rights. So why don't you save the taxpayers of the state a lot of money and make yourself some prison time and fill us in on all the details?
I told you my clients have nothing to say, Lieutenant.
Well, well, Mr. Shepley. Well, Sheriff, glad you could join us. I take it you've been advised of your rights?
My lawyer's on his way.
We've been sitting here discussing this counterfeiting ring.
You mean you were just discussing this alleged ring? If you'll recall, my
because we're not just talking about counterfeit here. We're talking about murder, and that's a capital offense. And one or all of you could be spending some time. And I'm not talking about the federal country club. I'm talking about hard time, state prison. And I'm not talking about 2 or 3 years. I'm talking about the rest of your lives.
My clients have nothing to say on that subject.
Hell, they don't. When I started asking questions about that picture you dug up for John Resnick, you figured you better keep an eye on me, didn't you? That's how you got on to Conrad. And that's how you knew Diana Huntington would be a perfect patsy for you when you realized you had to kill her husband.
I insist you stop this badgering.
One of you stole her car and ran him down. I'm as sure of that as I'm sitting here. I just don't know which one. You?
I told you I was playing racquetball that morning.
You?
Don't answer that.
I was at Shea Sal's making a sales pitch.
You? Where were you at 8 o'clock that morning?
You don't have to say anything.
I was in bed.
How long?
Don't answer that.
Yes.
So you can't prove you were in bed.
And you can't prove I wasn't.
Diana, what are you doing here?
I brought it. You wouldn't tell her I was making progress. She followed me following Shepherd. She blew my cover.
No, I didn't.
What do you call it when the person you're trying to secretly watch sees you?
Well, I didn't know you had a cover, so how could I blow it?
Diana, you shouldn't have followed Conrad.
Please don't yell at me.
Since when did you mind yelling?
Well, you know, Dr. Dennis Woodruff, the radiotherapist, I called him yesterday and I found out that my anger is just a cover for my extreme sensitivity.
Diana, you need therapy, but not out of books or over the radio. You need a bona fide doctor, somebody you can interact with.
You think so?
Oh, yes. Somebody who can talk sense to you. Promise me you'll get a psychiatrist, Diana. And promise me this is the last time you'll interfere with this investigation.
Interfere? I'm paying you a fortune for this. You're working for me.
Diana, do you want me to stay on this case?
Yes, dear Dan, of course I do.
Then you've got to stay away from here. Get a psychiatrist. Go see him. As soon as you get out of bed in the morning, stay there all day, every day. Now get out of here.
I'm not going to say anything. I just got to Carolyn Westlake's house, Ben. All right, I'll let you know what I find. Some readers at this house?
Got a problem with the bill of all the folks downtown, okay?
No, I just want to know how often you come here.
Once a month.
Always on Wednesdays?
Yeah.
Always at 8 in the morning?
Yeah.
Great. By any chance, were you here on the 18th of last month?
Nope, was here on the 25th. Gotta get out of here before the gardener comes. He always gives me hell when I step on his petunias or gardenias or whatever the hell this stuff is.
Vint and Naomi sitting in a tree. K-I-S-S-I-N.
Will you two put it on ice?
Watch the two lovebirds on Mama's Family. Tonight at 9:30, 8:30 Central on MeTV.
At Safelite Auto Glass, we know that when you're spending time with the grandkids, every minute counts. And you don't have time for a cracked windshield. That's why at Safelite, we'll show you exactly when we'll be there with a replacement you can trust.
Hold on, sir.
Looks great.
Thank you, Safelite.
Thank you.
saving you time so you can keep saving the world.
Eligible for Medicare? That's a good thing. But it doesn't cover everything. Only about 80% of your Part B medical expenses. The rest is up to you. So consider an AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plan, insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company. Like any of these types of plans, they pick up some of what Medicare doesn't pay and could really save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. Call United Healthcare Insurance Company today to request a free decision guide to help you better understand what Medicare is all about and which AARP Medicare Supplement Plan works best for you. With these types of plans, you'll be able to visit any doctor or hospital that accepts Medicare patients. Plus, there are no networks and no referrals needed. There's a range of plans to choose from, too. And your coverage goes with you when you travel, anywhere in the country. Join the millions who have already enrolled in the only Medicare supplement insurance plans endorsed by AARP, an organization serving the needs of people 50 and over. And provided by United Healthcare Insurance Company, which has over 30 years of experience behind it. Apply for a Medicare supplement insurance plan anytime you want. Call United Healthcare today. Remember, Medicare supplement insurance helps pay some of what Medicare doesn't. These kinds of plans could save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. You'll be able to choose any doctor who accepts Medicare patients. And there are no referrals needed. So don't wait. Call United Healthcare now to request your free decision guide. This easy-to-understand guide will answer some of your questions and help you find the AARP Medicare supplement plan that's right for you.
Social Security, and you need yours, so could be a blessing in disguise.
Well, okay.
Sure. And you can always keep on helping her pick out her cassava.
Well, yeah, there's that.
Would you mind telling the court what the charges were?
On the advice of legal counsel and in view of my Fifth Amendment rights, I decline to answer that question.
Then at this time, I would like to enter into evidence this arrest report that was filed at the time Ms. Westlake was taken into custody. For the record, it charges the witness, Carolyn Westlake, with the creation and distribution of counterfeit U.S. currency, specifically counterfeit $50 bill. Is that what it says, Ms. Westlake?
I suppose.
I understand that Jack Huntington, the night before he died, walked in unannounced on a meeting you were having in a conference room at your arcade.
10:44 a.m. I'm fresh out of the shower. Look at how the tire is bit setting over there. See how the bitch turned it up to a 3.7 from that 2.something. Just keep on watching because I'm going to let it record. That's what, an hour, 10 minutes and 30 seconds into this video?
I can put her on the stand, but if I do, then the three men that don't have to do it might be able to survive.
I'm checking the
Shipley and Dick Werner, two friends that Andy Warhol.
I wasn't showing them any Warhol.
Well, according to your assistant, Randy, Jack told her you were.
He was mistaken.
And according to Jack's girlfriend, he said the Warhol he saw was a sheet of $50 bills.
That is not true.
Isn't that some coincidence, though? I mean, you're showing your two friends a sheet of 50s, and a week later, you and these same two friends are arrested with a truckload of counterfeit 50s. I'd say that's a big coincidence, wouldn't you?
I choose not to comment on that.
He saw a proof sheet.
Proof sheet. It was your first run of 50s off your press. He saw it, you had to explain what it was, so you told him it was a Warhol. But you knew that sooner or later you'd put two and two together. So you stole Diana Huntington's car and ran Jack down in the street.
That's enough, Mr. Matlock. You're supposed to be questioning this witness, not testifying in her place. Objection sustained. I'll say this just once. Cut it out.
Morning of Wednesday the 18th, last month, the morning Jack Huntington was killed. Where were you?
I was in bed.
You always sleep in that late?
I'm a night owl. I rarely go to bed before 1:30 and even more rarely get up before 9.
That's what Lewis, your gardener, Lewis, the party, he's sitting right over there. When he started taking care of your lawn, you told him not to do any mowing till after 9 o'clock, so it's not too late. Is that right?
Yes.
Does he come every week?
Yes.
What day?
Wednesday.
What time?
Around 5, yes. I can't say for sure because I'm not.
That's not quite true, is it? He remembers seeing you driving away from your house one morning as he was just coming up the street. It stuck in his mind because he had never seen you up so early before. It was 7:55. You know what the date was? Wednesday the 18th. Now, you said you were in bed. Why did you lie?
I didn't lie. I just forgot.
Forgot what?
That I had a meeting that morning.
With whom?
Jeffrey Aiello.
Who's Jeffrey Aiello?
A businessman. I was with him till almost 9.
What was the meeting about?
You're going to have to ask him that.
Why didn't you tell me this before?
555-1057. That's Aiello's number. When you call him, you'll understand.
No more questions.
But your mother's my only chance of keeping my job.
I heard her looking for a guy to work the ship machine at the rickshaw.
You're pretty.
Thanks. I'm on my way to meet Craig.
Oh, crap.
Hey, these. Keep up.
Around the ankles, especially in those shoes she's planning to wear on her date with Clay.
Yeah, trunk-like.
Really? I thought I was retaining water.
Oh, yeah, you might want to put on some boots and some pants. Cover that mess up.
My ankle bracelet was feeling a little tight. I'll be more comfortable anyway going to wrap sushi.
This could be trouble. True. Boot season doesn't start for 3 more months.
Wrap sushi is that Japanese restaurant.
restaurant, we can give you dirty looks if you don't take your shoes off. Maybe I should tell Daddy the truth.
Oh, no, no, no. Clearly, you weren't raised by me.
A lie worth telling is a lie worth sticking to.
I learned that from a president.
But I digress. Daddy and Clay could have a good thing if you would just stay on track. You seem pretty confident he'd be fine.
Well, he's going to need support. We'll be hungry, because you're going to rap sushi tonight. Come on.
Do you want me to sneak around just to keep Clay from exposing himself and us?
Welcome to the ball. It's time to play by the DD. Now go!
Hey, I got you as soon as I got your message. What's going on?
Omar has something he wants to say to you.
French door fridge in a precision gas range. We're also including a Cuisinart non-stick cookware set and a gift card for ice cream and cupcakes from Sprinkles Cupcakes. The deal is worth $4,947.
Oh. You know, I know it's not the big deal, but to me, that would have been worth it just to get those Sprinkles Cupcakes.
The gluten-free Sprinkles Cupcakes.
Oh, this is so good. So you pick three.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Okay.
One, two, three.
It's an exercise machine.
So it's not the big deal, but it's a great deal. You look like you hit the gym.
Me too, yeah.
This Buffalex Tread Climber TC200 combines the motion of a treadmill, a step machine, and an elliptical for the ultimate workout. Plus, track your progress on the interactive LCD display. We're also including a water pitcher and a set of trendy water bottles. This deal's worth $3,459.
How could you pass on those trendy water bottles? Gilbert, congratulations. Now we have to show you what's behind door one. This is the big deal, sir.
Was a European tour. First, you would have spent 7 nights in Prague at the Aria Hotel in the Czech Republic. You could have enjoyed picturesque views, renowned architecture, and a gourmet dinner. Then you would have sailed on a 7-night river cruise of France from Travel Leader and Amma Waterways. You could have visited majestic castles and beaches as you traveled the Normandy River from Paris to charming harbor towns. Roger Bearfare was included in this big deal worth $28,922.
Okay. Congratulations. Thank you.
Bank checks a while back. Did you know that?
Of course not.
He wasn't trying to sell you something. He was trying to buy counterfeit money from you, wasn't he?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Only you and your friends got a better deal from Charles Beckman. So you told Mr. Aiello to take a hike. All except Ms. Westlake. And she decided to print up a few more bills, do business with Mr. Aiello after all. Only secretly. So she wouldn't have to cut in anybody. And that's what the fight was about in the corridor yesterday, wasn't it?
No.
And that's what her meeting with Mr. Aiello was at the time of the murder, wasn't it?
How should I know what Carolyn was doing?
You know, the funny thing is, when she got past you, she gave herself an alibi at the time of the murder. And she has one, but you don't get
it. I was at Shea Sal's with a prospective client.
That how you got those cuts on your arm? Mind pushing up your stick? Push it up.
These are not cuts, they're scratches. I got them pruning my roses.
They didn't come from roses. They came from this car. Diana Huntington's car. You're so eager to kill her husband.
That's not true.
But you sideswiped the post during the killing. And the window on the driver's side shattered, and glass came flying through all over your arm, and look, even up here. And that's how you got those cuts.
Objection. This is all speculation, Your Honor. And where is it leading?
Mr. Matlock, you have a knack for storytelling. Where is it leading?
It's leading to reasonable doubt, Your Honor. Reasonable doubt that my client killed her husband.
Proceed.
Thank you. Now, we were told about where you got those cuts.
I was at a business meeting at Shea Sal's that morning from 8 till almost 9:30.
You got those cuts in a restaurant?
No, from my gnosis.
Oh. How did you get to that restaurant?
I drove.
You sure you didn't come by? can?
Yes.
Well, the doorman at Shea Sound said you did. He's right. My car broke down. I called a cab. I was mistaken.
So you were late for your meeting.
Good, well, yes. Yeah. The red and white cab company says they didn't pick you up till well after 8:30. So you were not at the restaurant at the time of the murder.
I was trying to get there.
They said they picked you up at a gas station.
Yes, I had my car towed there so they could work on it.
Towed from where?
My house.
Who towed it?
I don't remember.
Wally's garage. I have the work order right here. E? You paid cash and gave a phony name. Why'd you do that, Mr. Lerner?
I didn't, obviously.
Well, this is your license plate number, isn't it? They wrote it down. They also wrote down the location of your car when they picked it up. See? 17,000 blocks of Cortez Avenue. Is that where you live? There must be some mistake. You know? No? You know where that is? That's right around the corner from Diana Huntington's house. He parked there, walked up to her house, stole her car from the garage, used it to kill her husband, then put it back, and walked around the corner to your car. Wouldn't start. So he used your car phone and called Wally's garage. Of course, it's one you could find, and they towed you to that gas station. From there, you went by train to the restaurant, didn't you? All because Jack Huntington walked in on that meeting and inadvertently saw that sheet of counterfeit 50s. He'd already been making waves, asking questions about that photograph. The 3RB5 gives John Resnick an alibi.
You see how the terrorist bitches turned it down after they turned it up. Stay tuned.